Yeah. Here we go.
This week on Autorestomod, George gets the last one. Oh, Jeff shows how to clean, repair, blast, and spray seats while Vinny washes his back.
Order a bunch of parts to get ready for the car show this weekend?
And I got a hot deal, too.
You think? Think again.
Oh, man.
Tired of back orders? You need NPD. With four strategically located superstores, orders are shipped direct to your door within 1 to 3 business days. National Parts Depot has quality restoration parts for Ford Truck, Mustang, Camaro, Chevelle, and Firebird. For your free catalog, visit NPD online or call toll free.
Yep, good to be back at the old digs.
Oh, no. Don't do that, man. No, that's the last one, dude. Do not drink the... Come on, man. Seriously, don't drink the last one. No. Don't open that. If you
open that,
I'm going to come in there. Well, if I get a key, I'm going to come in there and I'm going to get you. No, do not open it.
Okay, if you open it, don't drink it. Do not
drink it, okay? If you drink it, that... Oh. Look, I can't get in here.
I'm gonna use the garage door. Okay, I'm just gonna get in here. And I'm gonna change the locks on that one too. Well, at least it's not raining yet. After breaking into my own house, that old man's gonna kill me one of these days. Anyway, what we wanted to talk to you about is this. Last week we told you that we really recommend you go in and put your new TMI seat covers with the TMI seat buns. That way you're assured of a really good tight fit with the seat covers. The buns can actually recede over time, and though the vinyl that's originally on there may look great, the new seat covers might not work out as well. The new buns, however, will make it assurance that that will actually work. Now, starting off today, you're going to roll your base over and find some dirt daubers. You're probably going to see any number of different strange and crazy things on the underside of a set of seats like this. These have sat around long enough that we're going to go in and refinish the seat tracks, but we're going to have to get them off of here first. Now, there's four bolts typically that hold these seat tracks on these old cars, and we're going to take our wrench, and hopefully it's a half inch, and get these out of here.
Who's doing that? I'd have gotten attacked by something.
I got attacked by Granddaddy Longlegs. That's what I was afraid of. They're not wanting to move. All right, we're going to need a hammer. There you go. Have a hammer.
just set them down. Kind of miss Ape Tech.
I think we're fixing to experience our own version of Ape Tech right here.
Actually
you can't use this because it is a dead blow hammer and it's got this plastic head on it. So that's going to be a problem with hitting this metal. If you do that, you can damage the hammer. So that one's right out. This, however, has some potential. But I'm going to try to go lighter even though I really don't want to. This is actually a body working hammer. Don't want to screw up the head on that messing with this. Matter of fact, all of these are body working hammers. We'll just try the old claw and see what she does. A little. All right, well that got those out of the way, so we can now get the seat tracks that I'm tending to think that we may just get replacements from National Parts Depot on these.
So replacing the tracks, the buns, the covers.
Basically, well, I mean, honestly, it's pretty expensive to replace. You can actually now get the entire seat assembly from National Parts Depot. They actually have the seat parts available, both the tops and the bases of the spring sets. But they're really, really expensive. So in all honesty, it's probably easier to go in and do what we're doing now. Now, one of the things you can do is like I'm fixing to do here. While you're working on something, take your camera out, take a shot of it, because my memory is not what it used to be. Now we'll have a record of how that spring is supposed to lay in here. And we get to hammer the track back down. All right, on the GM seats, it looks like they used a lip configuration to hold the seats in, the lower seat bun into position. And you can just rip this stuff off of here and pull those out. You just need to catch a corner and roll them out. So far, we're pretty fortunate. Sometimes if the seats are in this kind of condition, you can end up with these lips being eaten away pretty bad, but these look like they're okay. You have to kind of keep an eye out because sometimes they'll use what they call listing rods in these seats. It looks like on the GM they stuck with the fiber setups, which makes it easier to take apart, but you don't have any listing rods available because they're all eaten up. And you can see that this is basically just a fiber material that was put inside of a really tightly wound cloth. There you go. That's how you disassemble this stuff. So now we're basically going to go in, take the buns off to get this ready to install. You'll note too, it looks like GM put a filler cloth in on the outside edges of these buns to make them bulk up a little bit better so that the seats will fit a little bit better. So that's kind of an interesting thing too, because I don't think those covers have ever been off those seats. All right, now when you're doing the stuff inside the seat area, especially when you got a lot of this loose burlap, I really recommend going away from the Dremel tool or the rotary cutoff tool and using a pair of cutters. Keep you from setting the house on fire. Just going to rip this off of here. All right. Now what you'll want to do is a visual inspection of the seat base itself. You want to make sure you don't have any rust through. You want to make sure that your tab areas, which these are for the seat itself, you want to make sure that those are still there. And basically you just want to take the rest of this off because you won't need it anymore. You also want to go through and make a visual inspection of your springs as well to make sure that all the listing rods are still in place, that any of these spring clamp sections like they put here are still in position on the seats as well. You want to make sure you don't have any broken springs in the centers. If you do, you're at that point probably just as well to go in and replace the seat base because sometimes it's a little hard to find shops that still stock these springs. You might get lucky and find them in an upholstery shop, but it's pretty tough. And we'll go in and remove all these old hog rings. All right, now what this is that I've got here is called a listing wire. What they'll do is these are actually put on the outside perimeter edge of where the bun comes in and meets the center bun of the seat. And when you put the seat covers back on, these wires are what you're going to use to hog ring the seat edge in. If these wires aren't here, if these wires are missing from your setup, you're not going to be able to hog ring these in and make it look right. They'll end up having a pucker effect on the outside edges of both sides of the seat. So always make sure that you put this stuff back in. If you don't, you're going to end up with a real issue trying to get this seat to set up and line correctly. I'm going to leave just a little bit of this wrap on here. We're going to use a cloth tape to go back in and reconfigure this setup so that it looks like it did. We might even go back in and put some different wire in here because this wire is pretty brittle. So we may rewire this completely. Right, so now we're in a position where we're gonna have to go in and do some parts buying. And what we did is we went to National Parts Depot and picked up some stuff. Our seat tracks in our car were in pretty bad shape, so we went ahead and got another set of seat tracks from them to replace the ones that were messed up. On top of that, we went ahead and got a few more needful things. We also got ourselves a set of these chrome handles for the seat tracks. Now, if you're doing a deluxe car, they came with the chrome handles. Yours may be in good shape, but if not, National Parts Depot sells them. We also picked ourselves up some new seat back release buttons because the ones on our car were in pretty bad shape. They've been scuffed around and look pretty tacky. So rather than try to do something with those, we just went ahead and replaced them. We also got a set of side plates for the car as well. Now these side plates were completely missing off of our seats. And had we not realized that they were missing, we might would have thought that the silver that the factory put on those was the way it was supposed to be. But in fact, they came with these, and these side plates actually have the fasteners that come with them to put them on the seats. The rest of it is basically hardware. We have the clip that we cut off, and then we also have some C-clips for this setup as well. Now keep in mind when you do this that the C-clips come as a set of four, but these little pieces right here are singles. You'll need to buy four of these to do a complete set of seats. We also got our bumpers as well. Now there's other things that National Parts Depot sells that we didn't really need. For instance, one of those is the seat back latch assembly. They sell these, but ours is in decent working condition. It's mostly going to be hidden in the seats, so we don't need to get rid of that and put a new one in there. We'll just restore this one. These are the door handle wear plate kit. Now National Parts sell these. They come as a set of four, and you can use them also on the seats. So you can get a set of these from them, but they're not listed in the seat section. They're actually listed in the door section. We got the part number there so you can take a look at them. This pile of stuff, basically everything in this pile over here is stuff that is not necessarily available from National Parts Depot or anybody else. These pieces we're gonna have to go in and do restoration work on to put them back in the car. Things like these screws, you can get these down at the home improvement center to replace what we got that are just kind of natty looking. The only ones that we're going to have a real problem with is we know we broke that one bolt, so we're going to have to try to find a fastener to replace it to put on the car. Everything else here is going to get a coat of paint, and we're going to be able to use it again. So we're just going to get busy on that right now. Okay, well now we've got our seat bases here, and basically what we did is we went and took these and sandblasted both the back and the base itself to get rid of all that nasty rust that was just covering these seats up. And in doing that, we went ahead and got all the large rust off of them and as much of the small scale rust as we possibly could. After that, we brought the seats back here and hit them with POR15's Metal Ready in order to prep them for paint. Metal Ready is a really good paint prep for etching the metal itself. We hit them with some Rust-Oleum Semi-Gloss Black, and after we got through doing that, we took the seat arms here on the seat back and painted them the correct silver that Chevrolet used back in the day on these seats. So now the seat back is pretty much ready to go. We don't really need to do anything else to it, but the seat base, it needs some work. Now with our base of our seat, we had some real condition issues on this thing that are gonna cause some problems whenever we start going back in and putting our hog rings in on the two forward facing sections of the springs here. These wires that you see right here, this wire is in pretty bad shape. The other one was bad enough that it's completely gone. So we're gonna have to go in and actually manufacture a wire that we can use to set the seat lines on there so we get the nice fold in the seat center section. We're gonna make both of them, but we're just gonna show you one. What you wanna do is go down to the home improvement center and pick yourself up a section of wire like this. Diameter, it's not really super important. Just keep it around the same size as the wire on your seats. And what you'll want to do is go in and use a Sharpie marker to set this thing up and get it started. If you're lucky and both of the wires are still in there, or one of the wires is still in there, you can go in and use your Sharpie marker to mark that setup and start bending your wire correct position. See where I've gone in and marked the wire, and I'm going to try to keep these to where it's basically in the same position relative, and I just bend the wire to a right angle. Check my positions again. We're going to take our cutters and cut the wire. Now we need to go in and take the wire and bend it back. If you'll notice on this wire that was originally on here, the wire kicks back into the seat spring area, and I think they did that so that you wouldn't have a wire hanging up and possibly getting into the seat buns. Now what we're going to do is we're going to wrap this in fabric tape, and the reason for that is just to kind of mimic what the factory originally did. And you'll wrap this pretty much like you would wrap a wiring harness on these cars. Now this was originally wrapped in kind of a paper type setup, so this is not obviously going to be exactly like the original, but it will give you a fairly good mimic of what they did back in the day. All right, now that's set. Now we got to go in and actually put it on the spring sets. And we got a huge amount of hog rings here and two different sets of hog ring pliers. The straights are really nice for getting into areas that are easily accessed, and then the angle pliers are good for going into places like these areas here to be able to get down inside the seat, spin them around and turn them once you've got the covers on. Usually you'll want to put two. Now if you'll notice on here, I'm going to put these on the position with the clasp for the spring right here. You want to get your tops and your bottoms set first and then go in and start tying in on the sides. Now you'll note that we also left this listing wire on, didn't take it out first. In other words, we left one end to show our position to ourselves to kind of remind us where everything's supposed to sit, and then did this one. Now we can take and remove this one and do the same thing we did over here. And that part of our seat base is pretty much ready to go.
Okay, we're getting ready to clean up the Camaro seat. Not sure what a Camaro is, but we're gonna clean it. And the object here is I'm gonna use the wire brush to get the heavy dirt and rust off the seat back. And then we're gonna spray it with some Pour 15 Metal Ready. And that'll actually do a chemical conversion on the rust, make it into a paintable surface, and then it'll be ready to spray. Any of this really bad flaking rust and all this dirt, you really want to get off with the wire brush. Now this is the inside, that's not going to be a visible piece, so you don't have to be as meticulous about the cleaning on it. The POR 15 Metal Ready will do good things for that. But on the visible side, anywhere you have actual flaking, any kind of dirt, you want to clean it up pretty good and then spray it with the Metal Ready, and then you can paint it.
Well, you know, there is another way that you can do this aside from setting it up with the drill motor like we've got here. You can actually go in and use the steel wool and the POR 15 Metal Ready. You can take these two items and work them together in order to make this whole setup fly. So remember, you can do it with steel wool and the Metal Ready, or you can labor away like Vinny's been doing with the wire wheel. Either one of these two methods is going to work pretty good for you. Now I'll let you get back to this, and I'm going to go inside and slave away on the seat bases.
All right. Yep. Jeff didn't say to put gloves on, but anytime you're dealing with chemicals and you're going to have it in contact with your skin, it's a good idea to protect yourself. So now you can really see the difference between the Pour 15 half and the half that we haven't treated yet. This side looks really good. So that's our show for the week. Next week we're going to pick it up with the reassembly and putting the pads on and then doing the actual seat recover.
Awesome. Yeah, and it's going to be nice. We're going to be getting that stuff working for you next week. What are you doing?
Oh, these things are a blast. Look at this chain I made.
That's not for making chains. Those are hog rings.
That makes a neat little jingly noise.
Do you have any idea how hard those are to get?
Oh, they're easy. There's a whole bunch of them right there.
Yes, and I had to order them from somewhere, and they had to come in via mail because you can't just go down to Walmart and buy them.
Oh, we're getting kind of low. You better order some more. Look at this. You can shoot them right across the shop.
Well, in the meantime, folks, go out to our website, www.autorestomod.com, And check us out there. We have a very active forum. We have literally every video we've ever done available on the site for view. We also have almost all of the stuff we did in this last season set up with the links to the parts going out to the guys who supplied the parts' website, so you can actually go out there and check it out.
Stop it.
Look, you can even play Barrel of Monkeys. Look at this. Your turn.
We have a very active Facebook page as well, folks. Go ahead and check us out on Facebook. We also have a Twitter account too. So check us out in both of those locations. If you want, go ahead and like us on Facebook and you'll be literally kept up to date with everything we do on a daily basis at Autorestomod. We also are doing something right now called Junkyard Dogs. And with Junkyard Dogs, what it is we take a section of a picture of a car and you have to figure out the make, model, and year of the car, and you win
a hot nose chain.
Chain from rings. I'm sorry, that's all we got. But go out and check it out. Well, we are doing something else. To the end of July 2012, we're giving away a free t-shirt if you write in a compelling reason why you should win a shirt. So go out and join up on that. It's good through the end of the month of July 2012. So do that if you will. And I need to get out of here with him before he ruins every freaking hog ring we have here at the shop. So, we'll see you later, folks. Have a great week. Come back and watch us next week on Autorestomod.
Thanks for watching.
You're like a 4-year-old, man.
You should make a bracelet out of this.
Oy.
Hog ring jewelry.